Today I will show you how you can put a hole into any wall. For example, for a window or a doorway or something. We start by getting to our wall. I just want to use this wall. So I will simply copy and paste this with Ctrl C and Ctrl V to here. I will put that a little bit back. Okay, so we have our wall. How do we start? We start by locating our wall by selecting it and locating it in the content browser. Then what you want to do is just duplicate this and we call it smcube_withahole. I will now, you probably have your own assets, but I don't, so I will just import something from the Crixel Bridge library. Okay, so I already downloaded some stuff. I will just use this doorway and drag and drop it outside. Okay, I think it just needs to load a little bit. So what we can do meanwhile, we can, the cube we duplicated, the duplicate we can drag and drop outside. And I will just copy the location of that to here. I will copy the scale and delete it. And I will go back to my cube that's here and paste the scale. So now we have here the cube asset with a hole and here the normal cube asset. We will see why we need to do this later. Our door still didn't load, so let's try it again. Yesterday it worked. I don't know why it doesn't work today. So it's downloaded. Let's re-download it for a second. Maybe if we hit add, as it looks good. Okay, now it worked. So let's line this up. Let's put the weapon away. And let's line this up like this. And we can also make the wall thinner. Like 0.5, 0.1 is great, I guess. Okay, let's line this up again. Okay, so how do we put a hole now in here? You start by selecting the object you want to put a hole in, the wall, in my case. Then go to modeling, go to polycut, and now something like this appeared. We can move it with these three lines, the blue, the green, and the red one. And you see, oh, there's a hole, but that's not the hole that we wanted. So in order to change that, we can rotate this axis like that. And now we have a circle, but we don't need a circle for our door. So what else can we do? We can either change the shape here to square, rectangle, and change also the size and stuff. Or if you have a complex shape, you can draw the polygons. So let's just do that. I want to start just here, or just here. Oh wait, it's a door, so I will start here. I will just do the window, like so. And now we cut out a custom shape. Accept it. And we are done. Look at that beauty. Oh, I forgot to cut this. So that's no problem. We can. Okay, and then I will just select the rectangle. So it's perfect. I want to rotate this 90 degrees like that. Just put it up a little bit. And then I will change the width to like 10. No, 25. No, 25 like that. Okay, 30. Okay, that's even better. 150 maybe. Okay, that's good. And now you can see it, how it works with another custom shape. Just exactly the same instead of using such a shape. Okay, accept this. And now we have two holes, as you can see. Perfect. So this is the way to do it. You can also cut the hole door and make the make so you can walk through it. And one thing I have said I will show you is why we copied this asset. This is because if we now go back to where it is located here, we can see this is the normal cube. And the engine just crashed for no reason. Good job. Okay, I hate Unreal Engine. So everything got reset. I will just cut a hole really fast now again, so I can show you why we copied this. The reason why we duplicated the first object is because now every object has a hole in it, like that. You see it? Wait, I will just copy the scale again. Look at that. So every object has now a hole, and the original doesn't. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video and want more. Goodbye.